Hi guys, welcome to PJ's Coin Capers. Today we're going to be going through some rolls of 50 cent coin rolls. So we'll do some coin roll hunting and see if we can find some coins worth more than 50 cents. So we'll go through these guys. If you have new to the channel or you haven't seen my previous videos, go and have a look. There's some noodling that I've done on some $1 coins and some $2 coins. If you can check those out, have a look, and also have a look at some of the other videos where I've gone through and shown some of the coins that are worth more than face value, certainly more than 50 cents. So that's what we're trying to look for today, is coins that are worth more than 50 cents. So we'll go through these, we'll go through five rolls at least, depending on how the time goes, but we'll have a look and see what we can find. So this is a 50 cent changeover coin from 2016. Fairly high mintage, so it's not one that I collect. I do have some bags of them, but it's not one that I'm going to pull out of circulation today. So we're making sure that we always rotate the coins, because you never know what you're going to find. And at one stage a few years ago, I did find a special coin that was rotated 180 degrees, which was an unknown error. So I do have a video of that coin, so have a look at that as well. So we're just going through. There's a few coins we are looking for. There's not a heap to find, but still we'll go through them and see if we do find any of them. There's quite a few commemorative coins that I don't keep because they're just too high mintage. Any of the state coins, that's a 2017 there. Any of the state coins I do keep, so hopefully we can find a state coin or something like that. It's a 2012, another 2012, and a 2004, which is a student design coin, but I actually hate the design of this coin, to be honest. It's a personal opinion, but some people might love it, but there's plenty of other nice coins out there. I just don't particularly like that one. So we'll keep going here. We'll see what we get. We didn't find anything in that first lot. That's a 2009 there. A 1994. 2011. There's a Millennium coin there. It's not an incused. Check out one of my other videos where I talk about the error with this particular coin. This one is not incused, so unfortunately we will not be keeping that one. So just look for anything that's out of the normal, is essentially what we're looking for. Something that doesn't that stands out as an error or something different that you haven't seen before. So it's a 2014, 2008. There is an error coin regarding the 2010, but this is not one, but it is rotated to about 2 o'clock. So if you spin it around, it's rotated to 2 o'clock, well then that's an absolute keeper, but this one is the correct way around. There is some doubling on that one, which is fairly common to see that. It's like a double rim there, but it is a fairly common error, and particularly on this coin here, the 2006, so I don't think it really adds any additional value. So 2007, it's a standard 2016, another 2016. And another 2016, so fairly common, the 2016s right there, and a 2011. So two rolls down, we haven't found anything worth keeping yet. Hopefully we find something. There's that one again. 84, 78, coins here. Another commemorative coin. A lot of the commemorative coins do have a high mintage. So I just had three commemorative coins in a row there. So we are getting a good variety here. There's a 94, an 84, 2008, 2014, 3 2014s in a row, 2006, and an 84 to finish off this roll. To our fourth roll. What's that? 2013, 83, 2000, but not an incused. See, it's just a standard filled Union Jack there, so. Yeah, nothing going on there, no fat lettering. So that one there is goes back to the bank. If you haven't checked out my video recently, I've posted a video where I did return some coins to the bank, and you can see that. So go and check that one out. And another video on getting coins from the bank using an automatic teller machine that dispenses coin rolls. So there's a number of branches around that now have these, or number of branches or banks really, that have these machines that can dispense coins. Okay, another commemorative, Australia Day. Another one. So 1979, there is a double bar variety, but that wasn't one. There's also a 1980 double bar to look out for as well. I should do a video on that just to explain what I'm talking about there, so I won't go into that now. These are fairly common as well, the 1981. And the 2016 to finish off this roll. Alright, let's go through this roll. Hopefully we can find something. Nothing so far. This is the 82 Commonwealth Games. Another common coin. This one here is also a common one. I haven't come across any state coins right now. 2014, 2008, 1969. So that's the first one that had this shape. Previously, they didn't make any in 68 or 67, and the 66 was round and silver. We're not having too much luck here right now, but that's part of the game. You're not going to find something all the time, so that's part of the fun of looking and hunting and trying to find what you want to keep. There's a Royal Visit one, but fairly poor condition. You can see the Queen looks a bit different on that one compared to... it's the only one with that particular Queen's head on it. I don't keep it. I do have some, but not that one. I'm not going to keep. So that's an 81, 2009, 79, 78. Well, we didn't find anything. Let's go through one more roll. Who knows? We might find something. Go for another one. quickly get through this one and hopefully find something. Alright. Nope. Oh yeah, here we go. So this is a state coin. This is one from South Australia. I'll show you a little bit closer there. That's one from South Australia. So I'll keep this one. It's not in the best of nick, but certainly well worth keeping, and they do sell for a few dollars each. So certainly better value than just being a 50 cent coin. And South Australia is a fairly difficult one to find as well. So yeah, absolutely, it's a good find, and glad we went through that last roll there. So I'll put that one aside. We'll keep that one. We'll keep going through this roll and just see if there's anything else worth keeping. There's another 69. So I'm just checking like for doubling. I'm checking for lamination peels or additional cuds that are on the coins. There's lots of different things to look for that make these coins special or unique. That's a 2012. Another Millennium coin. Once again, not incused, so it's worth 50 cents in that condition. So, no. What have we got? An 83. 2004. Fairly nice condition for a 75. Unusual to find one in that kind of condition. And we're getting to the end of this one. Okay, this one, I might as well talk about this one. This is part of the same series of these guys. So there's one for each state, plus Norfolk Island and the ACT, and I'm not sure if there's another one, I can't remember now. But anyway, there was this one as well, which is the mintage on this was a lot higher. These are around 2 something million. I think these are more like 5 or 6 million from memory. But they are part of the same series, but I don't keep them. I only keep them if they're in very good condition, because they're higher mintage. They're not as as sought after. So, but anyway, we'll I won't keep that one. And the very last coin we've got in this one here is a 2012. So, all right, guys. Well, we found one thing at least. So, but there's plenty to look for. We'll go through six rolls there, and we found one coin worth keeping. Anyway, we still had fun. So, yeah, make sure you check out my other videos, and soon we'll have another one up with, I think we'll do some 20 cent coins next time. All right, guys, make sure you hit the like button, and please subscribe if you haven't already subscribed to this channel. Thanks for watching.